Hi, and welcome to this training about MOSFET Fundamentals Part 1. CoolMOS, OptiMOS, Stronger FET. Have you heard about them? They are all MOSFETs. Did you know that MOSFETs deliver best-in-class performance, thus improving efficiency and optimizing thermal performance and electromagnetic interference, in short, EMI behavior? Nice, right? But what exactly are MOSFETs? That's what we will cover in this training, where you will get to know what a MOSFET is, as well as some basic concepts. Become familiar with the available MOSFET types and the main structure of a MOSFET. And understand the differences between the modes of operation on a MOSFET. Let's get started. First, we will give you a quick overview of MOSFETs. So, what is a MOSFET? A MOSFET, or metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, is a semiconductor device that is typically used as a voltage-controlled switch. It comprises three terminals, the gate, the drain, and the source. The main purpose of this transistor is to efficiently deliver power to a load. The MOSFET semiconductor has several application cases, such as point of load or board level power, motor drives, DC-DC and AC-DC power supplies, among others. As you can see here, there are multiple applications, and with each application, multiple MOSFET combinations are possible. Now that you are aware of what a MOSFET is, let's see how it works. Take a look at the MOSFET's electronic representation. As mentioned, a MOSFET is a voltage control device composed of a gate, a source, and a drain. The gate voltage is typically provided by a microcontroller or driver IC. By applying this gate voltage to the gate terminal, the current will start to flow from the drain to the source terminals. But how efficiently does the current flow through the device? We can obtain that information via the RDS-on rating of the device. The RDS-on is the resistance from the drain terminal to the source terminal when the device is on. This rating is measured in ohms or milliohms. Keep in mind that if you remove the gate voltage, the current flow will stop. Moreover, the MOSFET contains an inherent body diode. This diode is very useful because it can block voltage when the MOSFET is in the off state. Note that this functionality is very important because the voltage class, or the MOSFET voltage rating, is directly associated with the diode's blocking capability. Therefore, the MOSFET can be seen as a diode with a voltage-controlled switch. To make it easier for you, these ratings are available on the front page of the MOSFET datasheets. The MOSFET is available in many different package options, which vary in price and size. Here, you can see some of the available packages. Note that some packages use the three terminal connections, even though they may have more than three pins. Additionally, different packages have different die sizes. What is the die? It is the silicon present on the inside of the device. The right die size and package combination are very important when selecting a MOSFET because, depending on the die size, the thermal impact on each device's performance will be different. There are many different types of transistors in the market, so why should you choose the MOSFET? There are many reasons, but the main advantage is that the MOSFET only requires a slight amount of current to turn on, less than 1 milliamp. This means the turn-on efficiency is much higher than other switches, and the MOSFET can deliver a much higher current to the load when compared to other transistors, 10 to 50 times higher or even more. In conclusion, we can say without a doubt that the MOSFET is the most efficient silicon transistor solution on the market for voltages between 12 volts and 900 volts. Let's say you decide to choose a MOSFET over the other transistors. There are, however, several types of MOSFETs. Let's talk about them. There are two different MOSFET modes, enhancement and depletion. Both of these modes have two channel types. The N-channel and the P-channel. The enhancement mode means that the device is always off and needs a gate voltage to turn on. On the other hand, the depletion mode means that the device is always on and needs a gate voltage to turn off. Today, the most commonly used power MOSFETs are N-channel enhancement type devices. MOSFETs can also be lateral or vertical when it comes to their structure. What does this mean? That the conducting channel of the MOSFET is either lateral or vertical. In the lateral structure, all three terminals are on top and on the same side of the silicon die, as you can see here. It is very common for planar-type MOSFETs, and it may also still be used nowadays for low-power MOSFETs, such as small signal types. Alternatively, in vertical-type MOSFETs, the gate and source terminals are usually on top and on the same side of the die, while the drain terminal is on the vertically opposite side, as you can see here. This type of structure is known as a trench MOSFET, and it is the most used design by MOSFET suppliers today. For example, CoolMOS, OptiMOS, and StrongerFET are all vertical-type trench MOSFETs. Let's use the N-type enhancement mode planar MOSFET to deep dive into the MOSFET structure. As we have previously seen, MOSFET stands for Metal Oxide Semiconductor Field Effect Transistor. The most important element is the metal oxide semiconductor interface because it is responsible for its operation. Here, you can see the detailed structure of an N-type enhancement mode planar MOSFET. The basis of the MOSFET construction is a silicon material that is lightly doped with boron atoms to make it slightly P-type in concentration. This is called the P-substrate. To build the source and the drain regions, high energy and high concentration implants of N-type atoms are used. The gate oxide, which is built with thin oxide, is on the silicon region between the source and the drain, partially overlapping these regions. When the gate voltage is applied, the negative atoms are attracted under the gate and the N-channel is formed. At this moment, the current will begin to flow. Please note that other manufacturing steps may vary depending on the MOSFET type. Nevertheless, these are the basic operational building blocks of a MOSFET. Although we have covered the basic silicon construction of a MOSFET, it is also very important to understand that MOSFETs are constantly being improved and refined. There are two main reasons for this. One is to offer better, smaller geometries of the silicon inside, as represented here. This helps to reduce costs and enables the use of smaller devices while maintaining the same RDS(on) when compared to previous MOSFET generations for better scalability. And the second reason is to offer a better performing device with the same die size as the previous generations. Thus, the goal is to lower the RDS(on), which leads to an increase in the current capability, which, for the same footprint, enables an increase in power. Now that you have learned about the different MOSFET types, as well as the MOSFET structure, it's time to go over the MOSFET operation modes on a very basic level. MOSFETs operate in three different modes that refer to the status of the MOSFET channel. The depletion mode refers to the MOSFET in the off state. What does this mean? That the voltage of the gate is lower than the gate threshold voltage. The gate threshold voltage is the minimum voltage required to form the channel between the drain and the source terminals. So, when the gate voltage is lower than the gate threshold voltage, a depletion is formed between the drain and the source, and the MOSFET is in the off state. This way, no current will flow. Meanwhile, the accumulation mode happens when the gate voltage increases above zero but is still lower than the threshold voltage. This occurs at the beginning of the channel formation due to the positive gate voltage. Note that there may be a very small sub-threshold or leakage current occurring in the channel. Here, an inversion layer begins to form where the polarity of the P-substrate under the gate starts changing. Finally, the inversion mode has two types of operation: the triode or linear mode and the saturation mode. Let's start by focusing on the first one. In this operation mode, the current increases linearly with the applied drain voltage. In this case, the gate voltage is higher than the gate threshold voltage. The inversion layer increases and the N-channel is formed between the drain and the source terminals, which means that the current will flow. This current is proportional to the gate and drain voltage, which is higher than zero. On the other hand, the saturation mode occurs when the current through the device starts to level off or flatten. This happens because the current cannot increase linearly for a long period of time with the applied drain voltage. When the drain voltage reaches a value equal to the difference between the gate voltage and the threshold voltage, the conducting channel becomes pinched off and the current will remain constant. This pinch-off occurs due to the reverse biasing effect on the drain terminal caused by the increase in the drain voltage. Now, let's look at some typical datasheet curves related to the linear and saturation modes, where we can see the relationship between voltage and the output current. By analyzing this graph, we can see the relation between the drain source current and the drain source voltage applied for different values of the gate-to-source voltage. Here, the dotted line indicates the edge of the saturation boundary until the current increases linearly with the applied drain voltage. When this limit is exceeded, the drain current remains more or less constant with the increasing drain voltage. Additionally, this graph shows the relation between the drain current and the applied gate voltage for a fixed value of the drain voltage. As you can see, the current quickly increases once the gate voltage is higher than the threshold voltage. Please note that there is some amount of current flow before the threshold voltage is reached. This is called sub-threshold current or leakage current. We are now reaching the end of part 1 of this training on MOSFET fundamentals. So, let's wrap up. A MOSFET is a semiconductor device with 3 terminals, which is typically used as a voltage-controlled switch. The main purpose of this transistor is to efficiently deliver power to a load. In this device, the current flows from the drain to the source terminals by applying a gate voltage to the gate terminal. The RDS on is the resistance from the source terminal to the drain terminal when the device is on. When it is off, it is the inherent diode of the MOSFET that blocks the voltage. There are 2 types of MOSFETs, enhancement or depletion, both with N-channel and P-channel modes. Additionally, MOSFETs can have lateral or vertical conducting channels, with vertical being the preferred method. Finally, there are 3 different modes of operation: depletion, accumulation, and inversion. Want to learn even more about MOSFETs and the parameters impacting their operation? Watch the MOSFET Fundamentals Part 2 course. Furthermore, you can explore Infineon's comprehensive Power MOSFETs webpage, which showcases our extensive product range and provides additional resources for those seeking more in-depth information on this topic. Thank you for joining.